name's Ellen Weber. Originally I'm from Los Angeles, California, and I now live in Quincy, and I'm a photographer and videographer. I'm going to be having a show at the Thomas Crane Library, and the topic is statues of Our Lady as seen in people's gardens and in front of their homes. It's something that, coming from the West Coast, I noticed. It was something new in the landscape when I first moved here that really popped out at me, and since I'm a photographer, and something about them drew me to them, so I started photographing them as soon as I moved here, which was about 3.5 years ago. There's statues here and there, you know, definitely in churches on the West Coast, but it's definitely something that struck me as different here, especially because Boston and the surrounding areas are so predominantly Catholic, which is very different from Los Angeles. And so that just stuck out to me growing up with the iconography of, you know, being Catholic. And it's just so different from Los Angeles. When I first moved to Boston, I lived and worked in Dorchester. So just walking around the little neighborhood called, as far as I know, it's called the Polish Triangle. And so walking around there, that's when I first started noticing them. So that's where I first started photographing the statues of Mary. And from then on, just, you know, I drive around and, you know, something like pops in the corner of my eye and I see a statue of Mary. So, you know, sometimes if the lighting's right, I'll stop and take a photo, or I'll make a note of it and maybe come back and take a photo. But it's really just when I happen upon them, just randomly, just driving around. There's a lot of differences. You know, it's as different as the way people live. You know, some people take care of their homes and some people don't. And it's, I don't know how it relates. I haven't gotten to the point in the project where I've actually interviewed the owners of the statues, but that's something that I'd like to continue and maybe evolve the project into something different like that. But you know, some people have it really well manicured and have their flowers up, and some people it's completely overgrown and like dead, or like, you know, the Mary's right next to the trash cans to be put out, you know. So it's really different, and it's interesting because some of them are the bathtub Marys with the half shell in back of them. A lot of them are, but then some aren't, and you know, some are like the head, or they're cracked statues, or the paint's chipping off, or, you know, just like, I like the different textures, and just seeing the ways that people have their Marys out in their yards. One of the photos, I think it's probably my favorite image in the series, because it's a statue of Mary, and it's completely shrouded in vines, and there's just something kind of mysterious about the photo. I feel like most people wouldn't really like the photo, but to me it just, you know, it kind of speaks of the cycles of nature and the progression of time, and then also just how people relate to their statue of Mary. So, you know, there's some shrubs that are alive in the front, but then like she's like almost completely covered with these dead vines and branches. The promo image is in Dorchester, in the original place where I started photographing in the Polish Triangle. And this one I've photographed over the years, you know, in different seasons. And the particular image I used was this past spring when I don't know what kind of flower it is, but it's a yellow flower that's surrounding on top. And then I just liked it because it was really bright, and it kind of felt like the gold, like, you know, gold and blue are some of the colors that Mary's associated with. So I really liked that it was bright and vibrant. And on the ground you can kind of see the trash that's collected, but it's still really beautiful. And I really like the colors in that one, and how the, you know, again, the cycle of the seasons, the flowers blooming around her, and that kind of thing. That's probably one of the most, like, the nicest statues I've seen. And, you know, there's, like, the American flag, which points, you know, to kind of the American icon of, you know, of patriotism. And Mary's in there, and she has like a little May crown of flowers on her head. I think I actually took that photo this last May, which is the month of Mary. And you know, it's just like, you know, typical like white picket fence, you know, American flag, beautifully manicured, everything. It just, it's like perfect. So it's just one more example of how different the context of how the Marys are displayed is. Growing up Catholic, I, you know, the God that I was taught to believe in was male, and also along the lines of punishing, I guess you could say. There's like a lot of guilt that I felt growing up. So I feel like when I came into my own sense of who I was and what I believed in, Mary kind of spoke to me in the sense of being a feminine type of God or deity. And so that, to me, that felt a little more comforting. Like, you know, mothers are nurturing and loving, and that seemed to be kind of the guidance that I would seek. I wouldn't seek someone who was going to punish me for not being perfect and that kind of thing. So I think in the sense of just a representation of the divine, and I'm not really talking in terms of religion, more of just, you know, knowing that something's out there watching over you, I feel a little more balanced if I can also look to Mary. But when I see her, it's sort of a reminder that someone's watching over me and protecting me. So that's kind of what draws me to her statues in particular. I hope that people of all religions will come and see the show, because it's not really a religious show. It's just about seeing one aspect of how one religion shows their belief, I guess. So I think I just want to remind people that, you know, there is, you know, if they want guidance or support, that there are, you know, angels and, you know, like spirits around, and that there's sacred in everyday life that people can turn to and, you know, take a moment and reflect and, you know, not be so rushed and crazy. I'll be having an opening reception, which will be on Sunday, August 3rd from 2 to 4 p.m. And I'd love as many people who want to see the statues to come and see it. And I also would love, you know, if you can't see the show, to also, as far as continuing my work, you know, if people are watching this and are interested in being a part of it, I would like to continue to photograph the statues, and also interview the owners to see what Mary's significance is to them, and, you know, and kind of expand the project into to the people who own the Marys.